The devil did not overcome Jesus.
The fact is that he allowed himself to be carried by the devil.
Hallelujah.
If the devil carried you, if the devil can carry you for a moment, that means for that moment you fell. For that moment you are fallen. If the devil carries you, you allow himself to carry you to the top of the high mountain and show you the kingdoms of the world and tell you, the devil tells you, that if you worship me, I'll give you all this.
And we are to resist.
No, no, wait.
Yes, sir.
He says, I will give you all this.
Right.
Now, he is supposed to be God. All those things are supposed to belong to him. Am I right? All the kingdoms of the world are supposed to belong to Jesus.
Of the world, yes.
Yes. And this devil is offering him your things. Like me offering to you, I said, look man, if you worship me, that Bible you have in hand, I'll give it to you. He said, uncle, there's something wrong with you. I said, you know, if you worship me, John, I said, the specs, your specs, I'll give them to you. He said, uncle, I think you are not right in your head. Am I right? Because that belongs to you. How can I give you that? If I promise you something else, I'll give you my specs, then it might mean something. But your own property I'm offering to you is the most nonsensical thing. Unless I'm a loony, and you are a loony to accept it. You must be a loony to accept, I said, your specs I'll give them to you as a reward for worshipping me. So the man allowed himself, according to your book, to be tempted. And the Christians say that the Spirit is filling them, and I can see that it has not helped the Americas, because the Bible says, a little leaven, leaven at the whole. You need just,
yes,
you
right.
just need a little yeast
that's
to
right,
ferment
that's
the
right.
loaf.
That's right.
But if you have one third of yeast in a 2-pound loaf, one third of it is yeast, and if it does not ferment the loaf, there's something wrong with your yeast, or there's something wrong with your flour. There's something wrong with your yeast.
Mm-hmm.
That means what you're talking about is all nonsense. All these guys who have been born again, your evangelists.
Yes.
They one by one, the whole bang lot of them, 100% they have been falling. 100%. Jimmy Swaggart. Mm-hmm. You know what he did. Mm-hmm. Jim Becker, mm-hmm. born again Christian.
Mm-hmm.
Martin Gorman, Reverend.
But understand, and the word also says that, but many that says unto me, Lord, Lord. Okay.
You
have your Bible.
No,
Matthew.
Oh, okay.
Please, tell me.
See,
just turn to it.
That is you. That. No, that is speaking about you. That verse refers to you.
Almost definitely.
Yes, yes.
And to the Jewish
you are that guy. You are
the Jim Bakers of the world.
No, that doesn't refer to that. It refers to you on the Day of Judgment. When Jesus in the second coming, when he comes along, and you're going to say, Lord, Lord.
Have it
done. Did we not prophesy in thy name?
That's right.
And in thy name cast out devils.
That's right.
And in thy name do many mighty works.
Yes.
What you're doing now. Jesus says, then will I profess unto them,
I know you not.
I never knew you. Depart from me.
You were
going to
iniquity.
That's right.
Yes. In the Bible, it's a foot sack. Get away, your rubbish, your garbage. I don't even know you.
Yes.
So now I'm asking you. You seem to be a very clever man. I'm asking you, when you, on the Day of Judgment, when you rush to him and say, Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in thy name, in the name of Jesus? And in thy name cast out devils. And in thy name do many mighty works. And he's going to tell you, foot sack, you bloody rubbish, I don't even know you. Foot sack, get away. So I'm asking you, do the Jews, will they say Lord, Lord to Jesus?
Understand, no, they will not.
Will the Muslims say Lord, Lord to Jesus?
No, they will not.
Who will say Lord, Lord to Jesus? You. You are that guy. You.
Yes.
You say, Lord, Lord.
Yes,
and he
will.
And he will tell you, foot sack, get away from your garbage. I don't even know you.
No, you're not saying that.
Read it. Yeah, Matthew, that chapter 7.
Oh, yeah, that's it. Says it to those who will call upon his name.
Right.
But there are many others
that
are calling
upon.
But there are many others that are calling upon his name, because even Islam, Muslims call upon the Lord.
Nobody does.
If you call,
that's a lie. That's
call,
a lie. That's
you
a
call
lie.
Him Allah. That's you call him Allah.
Who is Allah?
Your God.
Who is Allah?
Your God.
God Almighty.
Okay.
That's God Almighty.
Okay.
Right.
But I'm just saying.
And that's his name.
I'm saying. But no. Understand. This is the point. There are many that are calling upon
God.
Not Jesus. Not Jesus. This is your
God.
Jesus. You calling your Jesus Lord.
Yes.
Right.
Yes.
Now, because the basic fact,
yes.
you call your Jesus Lord, and because he is not Lord, Therefore, he says, put sad, get away from me, you rubbish. I don't even know you because I'm not your Lord. The Lord is God, the Father in heaven. The Father in heaven, he is Lord. He is God, not me. Since you have made him into a Lord, therefore, he says, foot sack, you get away. All these miracles you have worked is rubbish, garbage. So, this hallelujah, say hallelujah. He said a number of times. You heard that hallelujah?
Yes.
Yes, I did.
Now, I'm asking, what is hallelujah?
It's a praise.
What does it mean?
It's a praise.
No, no, what does it mean?
Praise Jehovah.
You hear the words? Hallelujah. Allah, Allah. You hear the word Allah? Hallelujah. Oh, Hallelujah. Ya Allahu. This is his name. You see, in the genius of the languages, your Western languages, the genius of your language is that you use an exclamation mark at the end. You say, fire! You know, in the mouth, you say, fire! If it's written down, you write F-I-R-E, fire and exclamation mark. So stop! It's S-T-O-P, stop, exclamation mark. That's the genius of your language. In Hebrew and Arabic, we begin with an exclamation. We say, Ya Akhi, oh, Ya, oh my brother. Ya Ummi, oh my mother. Ya Allah, oh Allah. We begin with Ya, you end with Ya, exclamation. So Hallelujah is Ya Allahu, Ya Allahu, Ya Allahu, Ya Allahu. That is what we are saying. Actually, every time you take the word, you're taking the name of Allah. Because Hallelujah doesn't sound like Jehovah. It doesn't sound like Abba. Jesus on the cross is supposed to have cried out with a loud voice. Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani.
Yes.
And I'm asking the Jehovah's Witness. Does that sound like Jehovah, Jehovah lama sabachthani? Does it? You're a Jehovah's Witness?
No, I study with Jehovah's.
Are you?
I have no basic religion.
No, you got that Bible of the Jehovah's Witnesses, which means you accept that Bible as more authentic than that but these guys are carrying.
Yes, I do.
Right. So now they tell you the name of God is Jehovah.
Jehovah.
Have you heard that before?
Yes. Yahweh.
That's what they say.
Yahweh or Jehovah.
They say Jehovah, Jehovah's Witnesses.
Or the other one, they say Yahweh too.
They say they are Jehovah's Witnesses. They don't say Yahweh's Witnesses. They say Jehovah's Witnesses. So, I'm asking them, when Jesus cried, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani, to you, the Jehovah's Witness, I say, does that sound to you like Jehovah, Jehovah, lama sabachthani? No. Unless your ear is diseased.
No, it's all right.
Does that sound to you like Abba? Abba, lama sabachthani? Abba means father.
Abba means father.
Does that sound like that? No. Now listen.
Eli.
Eli. Eli, 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 Eli. Eli lama sabachthani in Hebrew, Allah, Allah lama taratani in Arabic, Eli, Eli lama sabachthani, Allah, Allah lama taratani. Sound similar? Arabic and Hebrew? Sound similar?
Yes.
So, who is he crying to? He's not crying to Jehovah, Jehovah, or my father, Abba, Abba. He's counting to Allah, Allah in the Hebrew language. In the Hebrew language, this is what it sounds. You see, in Arabic, this is what it sounds. It's Arabic and Hebrew are sister languages. They are almost identical. So when you say Hallelujah, it's like this, Yallahu, Yallahu, Yah. Congratulations to you. At least you have not forgotten his name. You have not yet forgotten his name. In your Bible, it's there. In the book of Revelation, chapter 19. Hallelujah is there. Eli, Eli is there. But the word Jehovah is not there. Did you know that? In the 27 books of the New Testament, not once does the word Jehovah occur. Right. So that means that look, who is responsible for those manuscripts? If God Almighty is the inspirer of those 27 books, then is he ashamed of his own name? That's what it means, it implies. He's ashamed of his own name. He doesn't want his name to be recorded at all. In the 27 books, not once does the word Jehovah occur. Did you know that?
Yes.
Yes. So that means that where did you concoct this from? How did you concoct this? You see, the Christian now is making religion out of Hallelujah, he's making out of baptism, you know. I don't know whether you're a Baptist or whatever you are.
I'm a Christian.
What Christian? What church you belong to?
I'm a Christian.
Yeah, what church?
I'm